Hey everyone, and welcome back to the channel. Today I want to guide you on how to enhance your privacy and security in any web browser. And our goal today is pretty simple, prioritizing speed and security and steering clear of unnecessary extensions to avoid risks and slowdowns. But why do you need to check in the first place and change the default settings anyway? Well, to illustrate this, after watching this video, go to this website, run the test, and see all of the information your browser reveals about you. Trust me, you'll be surprised. So this guide is built on Google Chrome because many other browsers are built on the same engine, but it applies to every other browser as well, so no worries there. All right, let's begin. But firstly, short tip, you can find a list of our top security app recommendations in the description box down below this video. So definitely check that out if you want more information and you can help support our channel, which we really appreciate. Number one is setting your default browser. First things first, when you open a link, which web browser opens by default? If you're not familiar with the inner workings of your computer, you may not even know that you probably have more than one web browser installed on your computer. If you're on Windows and use Chrome, you also have at least one more called Microsoft Edge in most cases. If you're on Mac, however, you have Safari and you might have a Chrome browser as well. But thankfully, setting your default browser is really easy and also pretty important. Which one you choose will mostly depend on your personal preferences, as the settings themselves are the important bit. And don't worry, we'll get to that later. But in our example, we're gonna set Chrome as our default web browser on Windows. But again, this applies whatever browser or software you were using. All right, so open your device settings using the Start menu, and in Settings, locate and select the Apps option. Scroll to or click on Default Apps. Look for the Web Browser category currently showing your default browser. Now click on the current browser to reveal other options and click on Set Default. If you want to set another browser as your default, you need to find that browser on the list and follow the same steps. And that's it, you've now changed your default browser, and more importantly, you know which one it actually is. And this will become super important. Number two is privacy and security settings. After setting Google Chrome as your default browser, there are quite a few settings to adjust so that your data is safe. This could take a few minutes to do, so this step is mostly an overview, and we'll delve into each of them more thoroughly later in the video. Quick note, I'm not going over any specific extensions in this video because that's an entirely different topic. However, as a general rule of thumb, you definitely want to install as few extensions as you can get away with, ideally none at all. Mainly because these are memory eaters, and some of them are serious security risks. All right, let's continue. Open Chrome and click on the three dots in the upper right-hand corner to access Settings. Within the Privacy and Security section, among the first things you'll encounter is the Safety Check feature. Running a safety check gives your browser a quick health assessment and ensures the basics are in good shape. Moving on, the Privacy Guide is a walkthrough for customizing your privacy settings. It introduces you to choices such as enhanced protection under safe browsing. And I would suggest that you enable that as it offers a proactive defense against dangerous sites and also alerts you about compromised passwords. Chrome gives you the option to block third-party cookies, especially useful in incognito mode, so make sure that that setting is enabled as well. While Privacy Guide provides a user-friendly solution to truly enhance your browser security, some options still need to be enabled manually. One of these is ensuring your browser always uses secure connections. By setting safe browsing to enhanced protection and activating always use secure connections, this will make browsing safer by only using the encrypted version of the website that you visit. Also check the site settings of your most used websites. You'll notice a lot of different settings that heavily impact how much of the information you share, and make informed decisions on what permissions websites have, from accessing your location to using your camera and microphone. Disabling unnecessary permissions, managing how sites notify you, and limiting JavaScript and third-party cookie usage are all measures to regain control of your online privacy. We will delve in much deeper into site settings later in the video, so again, no worries there. Lastly, keep your browser fully up to date. With every update, the makers of your browser enhance its security, ensuring that you're protected against the latest threats. And as a side note, follow this criteria for all of your software, not just your web browser, as fixes will always be beneficial. If you want to enhance your security even further, consider that your browsers are often connected to your email accounts. We've created a video highlighting the most crucial Gmail security settings as well. This includes implementing two-factor authentication and other important tips, so feel free to check that out here. Now, let's delve a bit deeper into fine-tuning browser security settings, adding yet another layer of protection to your browsing experience. Number 3, clearing browser history and managing cookies. You've probably heard about browser history and cookies, but do you know what they actually do and how they can be used to track you? When you browse, all browsers, including Chrome, keep a log of your activities, including the sites that you visit, your downloads, and your search queries. This accumulation of data can unwittingly reveal much of your interests and habits, and to counter this, it's wise to make a habit of periodically clearing out your browsing history. This not only safeguards your privacy, but also ensures that browsers run without the burden of unnecessary data. The basic and advanced sections for clearing browser history and cookies offer distinct options for managing your data. The advanced window provides more extensive choices for deleting data, allowing for greater customization of your browsing history and cookie management. But it can also be pretty daunting to use, especially if it's your first time. Go with the one that you feel more comfortable with and you'll be fine. Clearing all of this ensures that you've removed any junk files and data that your browser may have collected, resulting in a faster and more secure browsing experience. For those seeking a more streamlined approach, Chrome offers the convenience of automatically clearing your history and cookies every time you close your browser. To enable this option, navigate to Site Settings in the Privacy and Security window. Click on the Additional Content Settings button, and then select the On-Device Site Data option. Activate the Delete Data Sites Have Saved to Your Device when you close all windows setting. Now, every time you exit your browser, your data will be automatically purged. Activating this feature ensures that your browsing history doesn't linger, providing a fresh and secure starting point from each session. Note, however, that this will log you out of the websites that you visit, meaning you must put in your username and password every time you visit them after closing your browser. This approach to managing your browser history and cookies not only enhances your privacy, but also optimizes Chrome's performance, keeping it free from the clutter of outdated data. Number 4 is third-party cookies and site data management. To enhance your privacy in Google Chrome, a key move is refining how the browser manages third-party cookies. These cookies, different from the ones placed by the sites you visit directly, are often used to track your browsing habits across the web. Let's walk through the steps to configure these settings, ensuring that your online journey is as private as it can be. Click on Third-Party Cookies and enable Block Third-Party Cookies. Blocking third-party cookies is a way to block other websites, meaning not the ones that you are visiting directly, from storing cookies on your browser, significantly reducing their ability to monitor your activities on sites other than the one that you're on. However, it's not always black and white. Some sites you trust and use frequently might require third-party cookies to function properly. This isn't necessarily a privacy invasion, as they might use them to offer integrated services or personalized experiences. Chrome and other browsers know this, so they offer a way to whitelist such sites. Simply add extensions for any website you wish to ensure a seamless experience where needed by clicking the Add button, as shown on the screen here. If you want to view the websites that have access to your data and maybe delete it, you can do this by clicking on See All Site Data and Permissions. And in there, you can delete all of your data, or you can delete it from some of the websites. Regular check-ins on these settings ensure they remain aligned with your current browsing habits and privacy preferences. Number 5 is safe browsing. Now let's return to the privacy and security section. In the lower part of this window, you'll see safe browsing. Click on it to access options for safe browsing. This feature is designed to protect you from various dangers, including phishing sites, malware, and other malicious content. It has 3 settings total: enhanced protection, standard protection, and no protection, which is not recommended. Even Chrome suggests not turning it off, but what about enhanced and standard? For those prioritizing privacy and wishing to steer clear of web-based threats, setting safe browsing to enhanced protection is the way forward. In addition to being a shield, safe browsing is an early warning system. It provides real-time checks of the sites that you visit, downloads, and extensions that you may consider adding to Chrome. What sets it apart is its ability to offer warnings against potential threats before they actually reach you. And this setup uses the latest intelligence from Google's data network. However, as it happens with other security features, when it's set too strictly, it may break some websites. For these cases, standard protection provides a good in-between balance. It gives basic security by comparing sites and downloads against known threats, ensuring safety from common risks without extensive data sharing. As the name suggests, no protection removes all safety checks, significantly increasing vulnerability to online dangers. So again, we wouldn't recommend that. However, this setting might be used in very specific controlled scenarios, but it's generally not advised due to the high risk of exposure to threats. We can also select a different DNS server. The DNS server works like an address book. It tells your browser which IP address corresponds to which website. By default, your browser will use the OS default DNS, which is usually that of your internet provider. However, I recommend choosing a more secure DNS, such as Cloudflare or Google. This should also slightly improve your internet connection speeds, which is always a nice plus. All right, number six is site settings. Let's return to privacy and security in order to dive deeper into site settings. Within site settings, you can manage permissions for various website functions, including location access, camera and microphone usage, notifications, and JavaScript execution. For instance, restricting location access enhances privacy by preventing sites from pinpointing your geographic location. Similarly, controlling camera and microphone permissions ensures that websites can only use these devices when you explicitly allow them, protecting against eavesdropping. Keep in mind that if, for example, you turn off sharing location, websites that need to access your location may not work properly. Say you want to use a mapping website, for example. It will still show you the map itself if it doesn't have access to your location, but it won't be able to pinpoint you or give you directions from where you currently are unless you enter that manually. However, you can always turn it on again and turn it off when you are done with that website, or you could just go ahead and add it as an exception. Also, while we're here, another interesting feature you can adjust is notifications. Have you ever received a notification that seems kind of random, but also is loosely related to what you've searched for before? These are ads disguised as notifications. So let's take care of that really quick. When you click on the notifications button, you will see options for restricting all websites from sending you notifications. Below that, you have a button for adding websites that will still send notifications even if you disable them. And this is definitely an interesting feature to play with, and personally, I like to disable all notifications. Another option you might want to change is embedded content. Click on it to access additional settings, and the embedded content setting in Google Chrome offers another level of control over your experience, specifically targeting how external content is integrated into the websites that you visit. Embedded content refers to content from other websites, such as videos, images, or social media posts that are seamlessly integrated into one website that you're actually visiting. Think of the last time you found a YouTube video inside of a news article. That video is embedded content. Inside, you can see two options. The first one allows sites to ask to use the info that they've saved about you. The other option is to restrict all websites from even asking to use the info about you. The second option is better in terms of keeping your privacy safe. However, if some websites don't work, you can always turn this option on temporarily and then turn it off afterwards again. There are also other options inside the menu called additional permissions. An interesting one is Clipboard. Go ahead and click on it. There you have options to disable websites from seeing what you keep in your clipboard. You can disable this here, and if you like, below these two options, you can add custom websites to allow or not allow this option. But we don't have time to go through all of them in this video. I encourage you to explore and see what these settings are all about. It'll also help you to form an idea about all the information websites can access by default if you're not careful. Lastly, let's talk JavaScript. JavaScript is always a headache because it's one of the core tools in modern web development, but it's also a source of many vulnerabilities. The JavaScript setting in Google Chrome significantly influences both the functionality and security of your browsing experience. However, some websites use JavaScript for malicious purposes, such as scams. So you can choose to disable this if you like. Here you have the option to allow all sites to run JavaScript, which is recommended for the best web experience, or not allow sites to use JavaScript, which maximizes security and privacy, but may break certain web pages. For a middle ground approach, Chrome allows you to block JavaScript by default, but make exceptions for trusted sites. This way, you can enjoy the full functionality of sites that you trust while minimizing your risk elsewhere. And if I disable JavaScript completely, let's demonstrate the impact now. I'll navigate to YouTube and you will observe that certain features may not load or function as expected due to JavaScript being disabled. While disabling this feature can significantly improve your privacy and security, you may need to do some additional tweaking, such as adding custom behaviors for websites that require JavaScript in order to function. To maintain full control of your browser, it's advisable to keep JavaScript disabled by default and use this method instead. For example, if you're on a website like YouTube, where we are right now, Chrome, attentive to your security, may initially block JavaScript on the site. However, an icon will appear in the top right-hand corner, indicating the site's request to enable JavaScript. By selecting Always Allow JavaScript on this site, you grant permission where it's necessary, ensuring the site functions properly while maintaining your overall security settings. This way, for every website, you can choose whether to enable JavaScript or keep it disabled, maintaining security while allowing necessary functionality. So obviously, your browser is more than just a tool for navigating the web. It's your personal space for online banking, shopping, learning, and entertainment. And tailoring these settings to both your security standards and functionality requirements ensures a clean, safe, and efficient browsing experience. Regularly revisit your Chrome settings to stay ahead of evolving threats and explore additional privacy-enhancing tools to further secure your digital life. Keep exploring, stay secure, and enjoy the vast, dynamic world of the internet on your terms. Wrapping up our guide on securing any browser, we've navigated through key steps and recommendations. From setting up your default browser to adjusting site-specific permissions, you've taken control of your online experience, ensuring that it is secure and tailored towards your needs. If you found this guide helpful, be sure to subscribe and like this video to stay up to date on future postings. And let us know down in the comment section what your top browser security tip currently is. Thanks so much, we'll see you in the next video.